Hello, I'm doing a book review, and the book I want to review is Clockworks, Volume 5 of the Lock and Key series. Now, Lock and Key is a horror-slash-dark fantasy comic book series written by Joe Hill and illustrated by Gabriel Rodriguez, and published by IDW Publishing. Now, the series was published between the years 2008 and 2013. These comics were also the basis for the Netflix series of the same name. Now, I've already reviewed the first four volumes of this series, and I'll leave links in the description below to where you can check out those reviews. Now, the premise of Lock and Key is it's about this family called the Locks who moved to this small town in Massachusetts called Lovecraft shortly after the father in the family, Rendell Locke, is murdered, and they move to this place called Key House where Rendell grew up, and there the Locke children discover that the house is filled with magic keys. But the most dangerous of these keys is the Omega Key, a key that can actually open up the gateway to what is either hell or some hell-like dimension. Now, the main villain of the series is a man named Lucas Caravaggio, who calls himself Dodge, whose mind has been corrupted by a demon, and he's trying to get his hands on the Omega Key so he could rule the world. Now, throughout most of the series leading up to this, Dodge was pretending to be a young man named Zach Wells, and was pretending to be friends with the Locke children. But in the previous volume, Keys to the Kingdom, Dodge's true intentions were revealed, and he ended up getting killed at the end of that volume. However, his spirit ended up taking possession of Bodhi, the youngest of the Locke children. Now, what the plot of Clockworks is Dodge, who is now possessing Bodhi, is still trying to get his hands on the Omega Key, and of course nobody in Bodhi's family realizes that Bodhi is not Bodhi anymore. Meanwhile, Kinsey and Tyler, the two older Locke children, discover a key to this clock that could take you anywhere in the past. Now, it's not literal time travel, like you can't interact with the past, and you can't change the past. You can only go back as sort of an invisible observer. So, Kinsey and Tyler go back to the year 1775, and they see their ancestors during the Revolutionary War, and they also find out how their ancestors first discovered the Black Door, which is the gateway to the demon's dimension. And they also find out how the keys came to be. And then they decide to visit their father's past, and they discover how Dodge came to be. But yeah, Clockworks is a great addition to what already is a great comic book series. Like, Lock and Key, I would honestly rank right up there with Neil Gaiman's Sandman series as an excellent example of dark fantasy in comic books. And I like how Dodge is portrayed as a much more tragic character here, where you realize that before he became one with this demon, he was actually one of Rendell's best friends, and was a genuinely pretty good kid. And what happened to him was kind of Rendell's fault. It was also Duncan, Rendell's younger brother's fault as well. So even though it was the demon making Dodge do a lot of this shit, you could argue that Dodge fucking with the Locke family for all these years was also kind of a revenge, because maybe on some level he blames the Locks for what happened to him. And I think it's interesting how in this volume you find out that basically the main events of the series were all caused by a group of stupid teenagers fucking around with forces they didn't fully understand. So, it's kind of like a subversion of that classic horror movie trope, like a group of teenagers accidentally summoning demons, kind of like the Evil Dead in a way. But here it has more of an emotional core, because you realize that messing around with this magic is what brought Rendell and his friends together, and it's the very thing that ends up tearing them apart. And even the stuff taking place in present day is really freaking horrific, where there's actually a scene where Dodge, as he's possessing Bodhi, kills somebody. I don't want to give away who he kills, but the person he kills is somebody that we actually got to know in a few issues prior to this. But yeah, Clockworks is a very good addition to this series, and if you haven't read the Lock and Key series, I highly recommend it. But that was my review on Lock and Key, Volume 5, Clockworks, written by Joe Hill and illustrated by Gabriel Rodriguez, and bye.